Hey guys, Becky here with Design Bundles, and I'm super excited to have you join me today. This is a super, super easy and really, really fun project to use with either your Cricut or your Silhouette. Both of you guys are welcome, and I promise you won't regret watching this video when you are able to have your own hand warmers. All right guys, so let me show you what I have here. And then we will get started on the project. So I have already cut my HTV. Now, if you have not worked with flocked HTV before, that is what this is. It is a thicker type of HTV that will work very well on projects like this because it has a soft and fuzzy finish. All right, so I have pre-cut this. You can cut it with either a Cricut or a Silhouette. Cut it and weed it. This is flannel fabric, flannel and not fleece. And I'll tell you why, because flannel, this is a cotton flannel, and I do warm my hand warmers up in the microwave. So fleece, from what I understand, and I'm not a fabric professional, but fleece is polyester, and you do not want to put polyester in the microwave. So these are both a cotton flannel. I have a pattern. And I mean, this is still a pattern, but I have a pretty pattern and then I have a chevron pattern. And then I have some regular long grain rice. This is just bought from any grocery store or supermarket, that sort of thing. I bought it in bulk, and this is probably just under a cup, if I remember my measuring skills, and it is enough for two hand warmers. So definitely very inexpensive supply right there. The next thing I'm gonna do is I'm going to go ahead and cut a square. Now I'm cutting a square for what I consider just a medium-sized hand warmer. And I'm going to cut it 4 by 4. Now, I'm just using a paper trimmer. If you do not have a paper trimmer, you can do this part with your cutting machine also. Just load a piece of cardstock in there and cut yourself a 4 by 4 square. Now this is just meant to work as a template, so definitely nothing to get worked up over. I am only going to use it as a guide. So I want this bear here, and let's see, so I will do this bear and this bear. Okay, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put this down. I'm gonna go a little higher on this one here, and I can just trace around it. And I'm just trying to give myself a wide enough border so that I can cut this down without having any pin marks. I'm not gonna draw that one out. What I'm gonna do is put this guy here, and then I will draw this one more exact. Now for the chevron pattern over here, this will not be necessary because I won't be cutting out exact scenes, okay? But that's just my little cheat. So the first thing that I'm going to do is cut right on the inside and outside of that center line. Now, some of you may be asking, Becky, why aren't you cutting this fabric with your machine? Well, I can if I want to, but sometimes it's just easier, especially when you're trying to line up a pattern like this. It's just easier to do it the old-fashioned way. Now, if I happen to have a brother scan and cut, that would be different because the brother scan and cut will automatically scan in the pattern of your fabric so that you know where you're going to cut. The Silhouette and Cricut, unless you use something like a pick scan or the snap to mat, then that's not so easily done. Now don't forget to trim off this little bottom sliver. That way you don't have any ink marks. Now if you happen to have chalk or something along those lines, feel free to use it. This video is just, it's more or less created for people like me who are not very experienced with fabric. And we kind of do the minimum here, ladies. All right, so I cannot get those quite side by side, but I want to line these up the best that I can and get them trimmed down. Now, you can also work on some trimming after we have finished the project. You'll see what I mean. Okay, so we have our fabric squares there and there. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to heat press my design onto the chevron side. Now, when I set this up in the machine, I'm just going to give you a few tips on this. When I set this up in my software for cutting, what I did was I drew a 4x4 inch square. So the largest dimension this way or this way is 3 3/4 inch. That way I knew that they would work. All right. Use my Teflon sheet and I'm pressing at 320. I'll do one first and then the other. 320 at 15 seconds. And this will be a cold peel. So I will press these and set them to the side. And by the time I'm done with one, the other one should be pretty cool. Now I also need to tell you that I do put these together with hot glue and I do use rice and I do put them in the microwave. And I have read, number one, I've read some conflicting information regarding putting the hot glue in the microwave. And from what I understand, it depends on the type of hot glue that you use. I've not had any problems with mine. Mine is just regular hot glue. I'm sure I ordered it from Amazon, but just something to keep an eye out for. And I've also heard that heating rice in your microwave can cause problems sometimes because I guess the rice can dry out your microwave. Again, I have not had any problems like that, but just something to keep an eye out for. So once this is cool, I can just peel this off. And you do want to apply your design before you assemble, okay? Because obviously once you have the rice in there, then you do not want to try to heat press a design on there. So just to show you what those look like, they have a nice fuzzy texture. All right, really cute, love them. So now each one will line up like this. So let me get my hot glue gun. It's already heated up. I'm just gonna squeeze out some of my initial glue. You know, sometimes it takes on that burnt color. I don't want that. And I just want to squeeze a border out around my entire design. Well, that's not true. Around three edges of my design. And I'm sure you can guess why. One down. Now your hot glue work doesn't have to be perfect, but I would recommend to try to get it as straight and consistent as you can, because sometimes you can see the hot glue when you press these together, okay? So this is one pocket that we have. Ta-da, 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 super easy. Now, in case you didn't notice, they do actually make a hot glue that's specific for fabric. No, I haven't tried it out too much yet, but I do know that it's out there and I have some. But this is just regular hot glue. And I'm gonna fill it up with rice until it's almost full. Then I'm gonna come back with my hot glue. And these are really easy to do in bulk because they don't require a lot of fabric and they don't require a lot of heat transfer vinyl. All right, so once they're cool, you just wanna go around, give them a good shake, make sure you don't have any rice falling out, and then you can give it the final trim with your scissors. Now I put these designs on here. These are also really cute to do with a monogram or an initial, or even a little kid's design. These are what I feel like is a pretty medium size. So if you have little hands and little pockets, you may want to go a little smaller. And if you have some decorative scissors, that would be really cute too. They definitely do not have to be perfect by any stretch of the imagination. So don't be too hard on yourself if they don't line up exactly. These are just supposed to be a cute and easy project. And with the added benefit of keeping your hands warm, I really like them. Now, if the hot glue makes you nervous, then by all means, you can sew these together. I'm sure some of you are very talented seamstress and you can knock these out in a heartbeat. I am not, so we are a little limited to the hot glue. Just kidding. I don't think it's something to shy away from. I do think, these are at the heart. These are basic squares, right? So you can do it. If the hot glue makes you nervous, just sew them together. But guys, there we go. There are our little hand warmers. So guys, how did you feel about our hand warmers?
I think they came out really, really cute. I love the HTV and I also love the pattern on the back. So it's just really like the best of both worlds. Now, like I said, you know, there are a few considerations just to kind of throw out there for you because we do like to give you as much information as possible, but I love these, I love using these, and I don't have any problems with that. And remember guys, you can actually use this process, not just for hand warmers, but you can make warmers for the back of your neck, you can make larger ones to snuggle your little toesies on, so definitely a lot of really fun projects that you can make with this. Now guys, if you have any questions or comments, please make sure you leave those down below. I really love to hear from you guys. Of course, any video requests, I love to hear those too. And guys, if you don't mind, go ahead and hit that subscribe button, give it a thumbs up, maybe share with a friend. That's what keeps our little crafty channel going. And guys, I just really love to keep bringing you these projects coming in the future, okay? All right, great guys, I really appreciate it. I appreciate you stopping by today. And hey, we'll see you next time.